bladder cancer patients with more options than ever before. For years, platinum-based chemotherapy was the only drug treatment option. Then immunotherapy drugs were approved either for metastatic bladder cancer after chemotherapy or for certain patients who couldn't receive chemotherapy in the first place. Now there are even more new therapies.
First came erdafitinib. This is an oral drug that blocks a protein called FGFR. It is specifically approved in post-platinum patients as salvage treatment in patients that had tumors with mutations or fusions in the genes FGFR3 or FGFR2.
Dr. Guru Sonpavde leads the Bladder Cancer Treatment Center at Dana-Farber Cancer Institute. He says only about 15 to 20% of patients have the FGFR3 or FGFR2 tumor mutations, so other treatment options are also being researched.
We have a new drug called enfortumab vedotin. This is an antibody drug conjugate which has been approved in patients that are progressing with metastatic urothelial carcinoma, post-platinum-based chemotherapy, and an immunotherapy drug like a PD-1 or PD-L1 inhibitor. So essentially a third-line treatment or beyond. So that is a welcome addition to the therapeutic armamentarium, because historically we had chemotherapy like taxanes that have been used in this space, which are not very active, which induce responses in patients in around 10 to 15% of patients, as opposed to enfortumab vedotin, which induces responses in nearly 45% of patients.
Dr. Sonpavde says another new drug approval is for an immunotherapy drug called pembrolizumab, which previously was approved for metastatic disease, but now is also approved in the non-muscle invasive bladder cancer space. And he says research continues, trying to identify even more effective drug combinations and identify exactly at which point they should be administered.
There's other new drugs on the horizon. There's other spaces where these drugs are being looked at, like the neoadjuvant preoperative space, and also similarly in the adjuvant space, post-radical cystectomy, we are looking at different PD-1, PD-L1 inhibitors.